Hello Facebook Ads people, I'm Konstantinos, and today we are going to talk about the new iOS 14.5 changes. You have read it, everybody talks about it, the new iOS update is here and it has impacted the Facebook platform and the way that we are doing ads so much. Basically, nothing is the same. If you haven't advertised this year at all on the Facebook platform,
welcome to hell.
The big question is, what has happened? Well, there is a new trend on the market, which is all about the protection of internet users' personal data. Apple wants to be the first major player that will tap into this new rising market of protecting the personal data of all Apple iOS users by giving them the option to choose if they want to share their personal information for advertisement purposes or not. And of course, this has impacted all social media platforms like Facebook and Instagram. In other words, if someone clicks an ad from Facebook and lands on an e-commerce store with his iPhone and chose to opt out during the iOS 14.5 update, which means that he doesn't want to share his personal information for advertisement purposes, even if he buys something from the store, Apple is not going to verify the purchase back to Facebook without sharing any information about the user that completed the purchase, which eventually means that we are losing data, getting a higher cost per purchase, and of course less optimization on the asset level. Yeah, I can hear some of you screaming into my ears about the aggregated events. I'm not going to say that you have no idea, but I'm going to convince you about it later on this video. For the iOS users that chose to opt in, first of all, thank you. Everything will be the same for you, but for all the users that chose to opt out, you can go suck my you f**k. And now that you understand what happened, after my composed and super calm description, we can move to my screen and see all the changes together. Okay, and now enough with the theory, let's jump on my computer so that I can show you all the changes so that you can follow it step by step and prepare your accounts for the iOS 14.5 changes. Now, if you haven't done anything yet, I'm going to explain step by step how to do everything in order to be prepared. Step number one is to actually verify your domain name. This is a new feature and you have to verify your domain name. You have to do it if you go to your business settings. On your business manager, there is going to be a new tab which is going to be called brand safety. It's domains. You can see here that I have a verified domain. You click add. I'm going to do a test, test.com. You are going to press add. And when you're going to do that, it's going to give you three different options. HTML source code that you can put it on the head section on your HTML. Either a DNS text record, you can go to GoDaddy or wherever you have listed your domain name and you can add a DNS text record. I don't like the option of the HTML file. I think that the best way is with a head. It's super fast to do it. Then you click verify domain and you are going to be able to see that you're verified and it's going to be green. After you do that, you click on connected assets over here and you add assets and you connect your domain name with your Facebook page. That's it. Now, the whole game is being played on the events manager. And this is what I'm going to show you now. So if you go to your events manager from your menu again, you're going to be able to pick your pixel. Pick your pixel over here and you are going to be able to see all of the events that they are listed. And the first thing that you have to do is go to your settings, go here to, first of all, the advanced matching, click the show more options, enable everything over here. Okay, we are already losing data. So if we have more data, it's always better. So enable everything. Then you can see that we are having the conversions API. Conversions API is the new way of tracking events. Until now, we had the pixel, which was browser to browser reporting. With the API, we're having server to server reporting. They are working together. I'm going to show you in a little bit how they are working, but the Conversions API is also another way of tracking events, and they're working together with a pixel, so you're losing less events. You're having more data, so you're having better optimization, better results. So the API is something that everybody has to do if they want to have good results on their accounts. And let me tell you that the API most probably is going to actually replace the Facebook pixel in the future. So start using the API. I have seen accounts that by just using the API, they have improved a lot. Now, there are ways of doing it with a manual way. I wouldn't suggest it. It's a nightmare. I have tried it. I have failed. I haven't found good developers. Not like that you can find good developers anyway, but I haven't found anybody that who can do it properly. So I choose the partner integration. For those of you that you are lucky enough to have a Shopify or a WordPress, WooCommerce, it's going to be very easy. It's going to take you 10 seconds. Whoever is not having a partner integration over here listed, well, you are unlucky. Either you will have to wait or you will have to find a developer who's going to do it for you. But other than that, I surely tell you that this is something that you have to do. Now, how do you know that your API reporting is working? There are two ways. First of all, you can see here that we have browser server reporting, okay, the connection method. And that means that both our pixel and the API are working. At the start, we were having only the purchase event listed as a browser server integration. Now, all the platforms are working for all of the events. We can see that we have add to cart, view content, initiate checkout. We were having also a lot of errors. They are fixing that, they are adapting. And as Facebook announced, we should not care really about these numbers right now for the rating, because these are things that are going to improve by the time. Now, when you click on your pages over here and you view the details, event overview, we can see that in the browser pixel, we are having 4,210 events, and we are having also 4,298 events. That means that the pixel and the API are working together, and we can see that in that case, we were able to actually have 366 more events processed because of the API. This is what the API does. They are both reporting the same, give or take, events, but at the end of the day, we have the deduplication, which means that we are not have double reporting. But here we can see that the API actually was able to save some events that if we didn't have the API was not going to be able to save them for us. And that means that we were going to have less data, less results. So API is very important, as you can understand. I cannot explain more how important it is, but you have to do it. Now, the other thing that has changed is the aggregated events, okay? So the moment that you're going to verify your domain, you have to go to manage events. And I'm going to go on this account for that. And you have to go to manage events. You have to click on the, you see that it says domain verified. If you don't verify it, you cannot do that. So if you click here, you can manage the events, okay, edit, and you can actually add an event, pick your pixel over here and the event. And if you have a custom event, you can pick a custom event and you can actually list it. So now what is really important is that the priority for the stores, it has to be purchase, initiate checkout, add to cart, view content based on what you want more, the highest priority. And of course, this button here has to be open if you have enough data, the value optimization, because it's actually helping you to actually target people based on how much money they are spending, okay? Not only if they are going to buy or not. So this is a very important button. People that they care a lot about their lifetime value of their customers, they understand how important this button is. So when you do this for the first time, you will have to wait for 72 hours. If we click here again, manage event, it says, if you change or remove events from this configuration, you will need to wait 72 hours before you can return to edit them again. Do you want to continue? Now, you have to wait for 72 hours when you do it at the first time. Facebook recently announced that now if you do a change after you list them, you are not going to wait for 72 hours. You can work immediately on your ads. But the first time, for sure, you will have to wait 72 hours. On the other hand, it's Facebook and we cannot trust it completely. So keep in mind that if you change something, maybe you will have to wait for 72 hours. But the plan is that in the future, you will not have to wait if you do any changes in the priority or if you add any new event. Now, it's very important for you to list your events over here. If you don't list them, you will not be able to run conversion ads with your events, okay? So it's very important to have them here. If you don't, you cannot have events with your pixel and reporting and conversion ads. Now, as you can see here in this account, we are having browser to browser, so the API is not working. He wasn't able to actually do the API integration yet. So this is how it's going to look when you are having an account that you are having the API working like this, and this is how it's going to look if your API doesn't work. So now that we discussed about this, there's one last thing that I want to mention is the aggregated event measurement. As we know, the aggregated events are the events that Facebook is reporting back from any site for the opt-out users, okay? Facebook announced that this is not going to be a workaround for the problem of reporting for the opt-out users, but at the end of the day, it's going to help. At the start, the aggregated events were working only with the attribution setting of 1 day. If you go to a new campaign here, we can see that on the bottom, on the show more options, we can see that the 7 day click over here and the 1 day click or view 1 day click. So until, let's say 2 weeks ago, this was working, 7 days ago, actually, this was working with the 1 day click attribution model only. Now it's working also with the 7 days click. This is why the results are going to improve a little bit now, because we are having the aggregated events. The aggregated events are just bulk events that when they are happening from the opt-out users, Facebook is going to send them in order to improve the results. The problem is that with the aggregated events, we don't know who was the person that has actually did the purchase. So the problem with that is that Facebook is working like this. It says, Konstantinos bought something, I'm going to target similar people like Konstantinos, and it's optimizing based on what is happening on the results. So if we're having an aggregated event which just says somebody bought something, this is not helping us in terms of optimization. But on the other hand, Facebook announced that they are going to introduce something which is going to be called statistically modeling, okay? And I'm going to read it to you as they say over here. So in some cases, statistical modeling may be used to account for some of your campaign conversions. These results may not include all conversions from people using iOS 14 or 14.5. So that means that Facebook is going to try to actually identify who are the people that they bought. Okay, can they do that? Of course they can. The Facebook algorithm is very powerful and they're doing other kind of things. I'm sure that they're going to do this thing also. Now, how important is though the aggregated events and how are they going to help? At this point, I must say that I'm not super excited about them. This is why at the start of the video, I mentioned that if you think that the aggregated events are going to save your results, you are wrong. Because as we can see over here, on our normal reporting for the last 28 days, we're having 4.6K events, okay? And in the aggregated events, we're having only 111. As you can understand, the difference between those two numbers is very big. And if you think that the aggregated events are going to come and they're going to save you and they're going to save your ROAS, come on. At the end of the day, we know that it's not going to actually optimize and it's just going to be raw data of a sale. We know that the change for the 7 day attribution, by the way, if you're using 1 day attribution, you are wrong, so stop doing it. So it's a very good news that we are starting to see now the aggregated events being used for the 7 days attribution. I must say that for the last 7 days, I can see a very good increase on the results and the ROAS. So maybe this is one of the reasons, but I know that Facebook is going to become better and better and better when it comes to the aggregate events. They announced that the aggregate events are not the workaround for the opt-out users, but I believe that this is what is going to change the events in the future. The API, the aggregated events, all of this together as a combination, it's going to help a lot in the monitoring. And it's going to help also in the optimization. But as you can understand, right now, it's not it's not a very big difference, okay? So just to summarize, the most crucial things that you need to take care when you're starting now and you haven't advertised for a period, or if you haven't done it, is first of all, domain verification. You need to do your domain verification. Second thing is that you need to go and you need to list your events in the aggregated events so that you will be able to use them. Install your API, turn on all the buttons on the advanced matching, and start receiving better results. If you don't do these changes, keep in mind that you're going to be struggling and you're going to be left behind in terms of results. So do the changes as fast as you can. And let's wrap it up from here. I'm going to see you for the closing of this video. One last thing that is really bothering me, and I actually consider it one of the worst developments on the platform, is that the breakdown of results are not available anymore. And because I'm so pissed about it, I'm going to do a whole video about this topic. The changes are here to stay. We don't know if Android will follow, since this is how the competition works after all. I'm sure that Facebook will find the solution, like they always do. If Facebook can do it, who is going to? The smaller platforms like TikTok or Snapchat will struggle even more with the changes. I'm not going to say that it is better now than before, because it's simply not. But we will adapt as marketeers and business owners, as we always do. To be honest with you, after the changes, the results on the platform were not stable at all. Several accounts had issues, but I can see that things are becoming better day by day. Before we wrap up, I need to point out that in my eyes, this is a big opportunity for business owners and marketeers. Whoever can't afford it anymore and whoever can't make the ads work anymore will leave the platform. And in my opinion, this will be the reason for the rising cost of advertising on the Facebook platform to at last start dropping instead of increasing steadily every year. Paradoxically, it is an opportunity after all. In any case, that's all I had for you about the Facebook iOS 14 changes. Hit the like button if you like the video and subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But even if you don't, if you feel like it, leave your comments and questions below with the hashtag AskKonstantinos, and your question might be featured in a future video. And don't forget that if you want to learn more about Facebook ads, you can read my book or check my courses. Links are below in the description. Until we meet again, be creative and consistent.